Hello everyone. Today I will be discussing a problem named farming figures. This was a question of TCS CodeVita Prequalifier round of zone 2 and how I solved it. Okay. So let's start discussing the question. The question was given such that there are n sites and then we have to print the maximum number of sites in the polygon which we can make from these n sites. Okay. And the given constraint was the n is greater than equal to 1 and less than equal to 100. Okay. So for example, like if the given number of sides are 3 and 1 1 1, okay, we all know we can make a triangle. Okay, triangle from this, so output will be 3. If given number of sides is 4 1 1 1 1, we can make a square from this or a triangle with 3 sides. Okay, so we have to output the maximum number of sides in the biggest polygon we can make. Okay, so here it will be 4. Okay, so the first thing which comes into mind by seeing this question is the triangle inequality law. Now, which states that the each side should be less than the sum of other two sides. Okay, now this is really very important property which I will be using to solve this question. Like each side should be less than sum of other two sides. But then you will be thinking, like, this can be only applied to a triangle. How will solve a bigger polygon like square or pentagon or heptagon or maybe a polygon with 15 sides? Okay, so let me write a generalized formula of this triangle inequality for any number of sides polygon. Okay, any size polygon. Okay, which states like each side should be less than equal to, okay, sum of all sides by 2. Okay, now this theorem states, this is the generalized form of triangle inequality for any number of sides. Okay, now this is important. Okay, so let's see how we will be using this. Okay, let's say like a given number of sides is 5. Okay, and sides are 1 6 8 2 3. Okay, so let's check for the biggest size, is it less than or not. So the sum here is 1 plus 6 7, 7 plus 8 is 15, 15 plus 2 17, 17 plus 3 is 20. So 20 by 2 is 10. Okay, so obviously this is less, so other sides are also less than equal to this 10. So we can make a pentagon from this 5 sides. Okay, now let's consider a case like where this property violates. Okay, let's consider this given number of sides is 6 and sides are 100, bigger size. Okay, 8 3 2, and let's say again 4. Okay, so here obviously you can see like 100 will not be less than this sum. Okay, but just I will show you 100. And the sum here is 1 plus 8, 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, 12 plus 2, 14, 14 plus 4, 18, so 118 is not less than 118 by 2, okay, which will be 59, okay, obviously this is not, so we cannot make a six-sided polygon from these sides. Okay, now we'll check from 5, with number of sides 5, okay. So what we have to do is, while we go down, no, we have to select 5 sides from these given 6 sides. So we have to actually make combinations. Okay, now if we can make several combinations like 100, 8, 3 and 2. We can select 1, 8, 3, 2, 4. We can select 100, 4, 3, 8. Means any means. So there will be a total of 6C5, means total of 6 combinations we can make, right? Now we have to check each of the combinations for this property. Okay, so that the each side in this polygon, in this selection, is less than the total sum by 2. Okay, now in this case it won't be, in this case it won't be, and similarly we can eliminate other cases. And if we get any other case, like okay, this is the case, no, okay, this case is possible, so we just print 5 and we get our loop. Okay, break. Okay, so my logic is that simple. Like first we'll be selecting, checking the whole list, and if it is possible, then okay, we'll print it and we'll exit. If not, then we'll check for the in decreasing order. So because the question states like have to print the maximum number of sides. Okay, obviously we can make a triangle from these. Okay, so okay, so let's yes, and one more thing to be noted is like a polygon must be, must contain more than 2 sides, right? Because with 2 sides we cannot make any polygon, so obviously at least the number of sides should be 3. Okay, so let's go to my code and I will explain how I performed all these. Okay, in my code, so finish. Okay, this was my code. Okay, I used a public variable counter, which I will be using. Like this counter will specify me like whether I found a solution to the problem or not. Okay, and here check each method is like if given an array and r, okay, where r is the number of okay, so the number of data in this, okay, in, and then I will be checking if like I will be I first calculate your total sum, and then if each element is less than the sum or not, and then if the if each element is less than equal to the sum, is less than the sum by 2, then okay, I increment counter and print number of sides and break. Okay, should break. Okay, and here this function generates n number of combinations. Okay, the ncx part I talked about, this function here, this generates for each number of combination from the given full array. Okay, now let's see, now let me explain you the flow from main. Okay, now I've used the buffer reader to take input from of that full array. Okay, I used a full array variable and then stored all sides in this full array, and then for each side I'm just I told you like if it is not possible for 6 I must come down, right? So I'm just checking down from length to 2, it should be greater than 2. I told you right, side should be greater than at least minimum number of sides should be 3, right? So it should be greater than 2. For each one I'm just checking a polygon if it is possible or not. Okay, if the counter is 0 after full my program execution, okay, then I will just print 0. Okay, now here what we are calling is check polygon, right? So now let's go to check polygon. Now check polygon, what it does is it generates a new double data, and it puts of that length that data into this combination function. Okay, and which then populates this data with means generates a combination, and then we check for each then we check the each array of length r. If possible, then we print that number of sides and we are done. Because like once if the counter is incremented, we won't be doing further calculations or checking further. Okay, so this was it. I will put a link to my code, and then if you guys have found a better solution to this problem, then please do comment below and let me know. Okay, thank you.